Shivratri for us is a annual affair of affection and goodwill, backed up by music and a common purpose of well-being. Entire village will come with two purposes. One, that we are participating in a conglomeration of joy, and second, that we will be able to get our provisions for the year. And the worship took place. That was the beginning of Shivratri fairs. The temporal political purpose is solved, the religious purpose is solved, code of conduct. And that code of conduct is that first you go to the royalty and then you go to the divinity. Without divinity's ashirvad, the function will be nothing. When they came here, they all went to pay their obeisance to the ruler, which was Madhura. And this goes even up till today. And Madhurai's doors will open to a particular devata. So then he will lead all the devatas when they have come on the Shivratri day to the Shiva. It is a time when soothsayers come in abundance, but their soothsayers were different. They don't open a patri. They go into a trance. They develop, and then they make a forecast or tell you a method that you do this or do that. You have no objection to doubt, because this is how they live. This is how they practice. They always knew when it is going to be a good weather for sowing. It was in their system. It is in our system, but we have lost it. It needs a purpose which should be holy. And it needs persons who have a reason to create joy. So that joy, the devatas' music invigorates them. And it is practiced jointly, year after year. If Shivratri is not there in Mandi, we feel that spirit of Mandi is gone, totally. That you come from a place where the ruling deity is also a deity and men work in his name. That makes it holistic. And the deity says that yes, I may have the paramount power, I may have the power, physical power, but I have to seek blessings of the spiritual deity, that is Shiva. And Shivratri is all over the country. And Shivratri, until independence took place, as it is, the way it was celebrated in Mandi, it was never done anywhere else in Himachal. Maybe even now it is not done. Consolidation of the state was one purpose. Communication with those areas was second purpose. Winning their loyalty was third purpose. And fourth purpose was that to join hands in a holistic way, not the slavery and malignance. And it is to the great credit of Pahadis that they still hold good to these values. Paramatma kare, they may not vanish.